I told you to leave me alone. So give me some space, bug eye. Your breath smells like Bantha Poodoo.
Kuyami, Juski, Chika Nai. Tong Patoga Smaktilia. The beast, you bong, kooky, punkpa. Tong Itwamaji, human ak in Ikatune.
Who you call a little girl, Chuba Face?
Ubabatu Konchi. She's got a soki, Koopa Bona na Chachu.
Just a sec, boys. Zalbar, a little help here? I need you to rip the legs off some insects. Quit complaining. You can finish eating later. Besides, you need the exercise, so get over here.
Kiyokaku! Kinba muli ra duanaji! Kuyami juski chika nai! Uba maska duana chichopa muska! Jiska da soki kupa bona na chachu!
You got a problem with me? Then you got a problem with Big Z. So unless you want to take on my furry friend, I suggest you greenies hop on out of here.
Chubasa! Kinba muli ra duanaji! Kaba volpa murji guma ya!
I saw Davik's new starship at the spaceport before the quarantine. They say it's the fastest ship on Taris. Calls it the Ebon Hawk.
Say, I don't recognize you, and I know pretty much everyone in the lower city. You must be new down here. I guess that makes me and Big Z your official welcoming committee. It's not that strange. Most aliens can speak basic, they just prefer to use their own language. But I grew up here on Taris, so I just sort of got used to speaking the native tongue.
You showed a lot of guts dealing with those Valkyrs, kid. You got a name?
My name's Mission Veo, and this big Wookiee is my best friend Zalbar. I'd offer to give you a tour, but the streets down here aren't safe. But if there's anything else you need... We just kind of fell in together. It ain't easy on your own here in the lower city. Everyone's always looking to push you around.
So we noticed. Still, you seem like an odd pair.
When I met up with Zalbar, seemed like a pretty good match. I knew we could look out for each other. With my street smarts and his muscle, we make a great team. Well, you came to the right person. If you want info on Lower Taris, I'm the one to talk to. Davik, the Lower City gangs. I even got the scoop on that bounty hunter, Kalo Nord. Davik's part of the Intergalactic Crime Syndicate, but I guess everyone knows that. But I hear he's got a new ship for his smuggling operations, the Ebon Hawk. I don't know much about space travel, but I hear that ship's fast enough to break the Sith blockade. Of course, this is all just secondhand rumor.
Where would he keep it, do you know?
If Davik does have a ship, he's got it locked up in his estate. Nobody gets in there, except the people working for Davik and the Exchange. There's only two gangs worth worrying about here in the lower city. The Black Bulkers and the Hidden Beks. Sometimes Zalbar and I hang out at the Bek base. The Beks are led by Gadden Thek. He's a good guy. Lost his sight in a swoop bike accident a few years ago, but even blind, he's a great leader. Not like that traitor, Brezhik. Before he took over the Bulkers, he was a Hidden Bek. Gadden considered that ungrateful space slug his adopted son. When Gadden went blind, everyone figured he'd step down and appoint Brezhik in his place. But Gadden figured Brezhik wasn't ready yet. He wanted him to wait a few years. But Brezhik was too impatient. He left to join the Bulkers, and ever since, he's been waging a war to wipe Gadden and his Beks from the face of Taris. This gang war in the lower city is totally the Bulkers' fault. They're the ones killing everything that moves out on the street. It's like they've gone insane. Kalo Nord's one of the most famous bounty hunters in the galaxy. He's killed more people than the Iridian Plague. I've seen him kill people just for trying to talk to him. He hangs around Zack's bounty office, but I don't think he's looking for work there. All the postings there are small time, way beneath a bounty hunter of his caliber. I figure Kalo's been hired by Davik to do a special job for the Exchange. I'd wager 1,000 credits that as soon as the quarantine ends, he'll be getting off this rock. You going? Yeah, this dive is pretty boring. No action around here. Come on, Big Z, let's go. Can't you think about something besides your stomach for 5 minutes? Come on. We'll go see if there's anything good to eat at the Bek base.
Uchua penki. Tongi dwamaji, human ak un inkatune. Chi ita kanki, chan na kilikon. Chi wak aita kanki. Ki muli ra kun king. Tong hi dwama ak inkotune. Chao baso. Gino Molirani Bubo Tonkin Ba Noku Netsag Patoga Yak Fuli Kokala Gigi Tinkuin Koka Tonghit Wana Gi Sakat Agi Inko Tune Chula Molira Tonkpa Noku Nek Abog Smilia Tinkuin Koka Patoga Yak Fuli Kokala Gigi Ki Molira Kunkin Tong hit wama ak inko tune. Topa na oto bokasa. Pampa ki muli ra kun king. Chang wapa chin lo shang wi chama u cha wish u yong kun. Kimba no kun nik docha. Patisa, patisa! Uba baska dwana chichopa muska Kimba nikcha loda kun Ki yuma batmaliaw no wish Kakin cha nawabagaon Kun muli ras limo poiwanga Tok kimba no kun neksag Chachiska Topa na oto bokasa Kakin cha nawabagaon Bagua shang konti machit
I heard Davik's hired a Mandalorian mercenary to work for him. I didn't know there were any of them left after the Mandalore Wars.
Huh? What? Oh, sorry. I didn't see you there. My attention was kind of focused on the twi'lek dancers. Look at them waggle those head tails. Don't worry, honey. Alien girls aren't really my thing. I'm much more interested in an attractive female of my own species. You're here about that? I guess Zax must have mentioned me to you at the bounty office. Fair enough. I don't care who takes her out. Just so long as the job gets done, I can't let her get away with what she did. That wench tried to cut me with her vibro blade. Because she's crazy. She started screaming that I was making advances, and the next thing I know, she's coming at me with a knife.
Yeah, right. Sounds to me like she was defending herself.
I admit I was drunk. Maybe I got a little fresh. But it was no big deal. She didn't have to cut me. What? I can't do that. Think how it would look. I work for Davik. I've got a certain reputation to uphold. I can't let her get away with this. There has to be payback. Although, I do feel a little guilty about all this. Dia's a good-looking gal. It'd be a shame to kill her. Tell you what, I'll take 200 credits in exchange for lifting the bounty. If I let her get away with it, I'll look even worse. She's got to pay, either with her life or 200 credits to buy my forgiveness. You can do that if you want, but I doubt she's got 200 credits. That's a lot, and she's just a working girl. But that's the breaks, right? Hate to see a pretty lady leaving, but you ain't the only girl in this place. I guess I'll go back to enjoying the dancers.
What?
Hey, you can't just walk in here. This is the hidden back base. How do I know you're not a Volker spy sent to kill Gaddon Thek? A lot of people want to go inside and speak to Gaddon. He's a hero of the common folk. But the days of the Hidden Beck's open door policy are gone. Between the Sith conquest and the Volker gang war, Gaddon has more enemies than he used to. We're being careful about who we let in now. Well, we do need all the help we can get. And you don't look like you're with the Volkers or the Sith. Besides, it's not like you can do anything to harm Gaddon in the heart of his own base. Not with Zerdra watching his back. Go in and speak to Gaddon if you want. Just remember to be on your best behavior. The Hidden Becks are watching you.
Un pacu, paliamu capata, bonana chaku, y con cono pule marachico. Tongna bonsha nunya, cavavolpa multi gunna.
Hold it right there. Who are you, and what is your business with Gaddon?
Calm down, Zerdra. Nobody's going to try anything here in the middle of our own base. It would be a suicide mission.
You're too trusting, Gaddon. Brezhik and his Volkers want you dead. Anyone we don't know is a potential threat, and it's my job to make sure you're safe.
Do you want us to start attacking strangers on sight, Zerdra? Like the Volkers do? I will never let it come to that. Now step aside and let them pass.
As you wish. You can speak to Gaddon if you want, but I've got my eye on you. You try anything and you'll be vaporized before you can say Volker spy.
You'll have to forgive Zerdra. Ever since Brezhik and the Volkers began this war against us, she's been a little overzealous in her security duties. And the problems with the Sith haven't helped things. Zerdra seems to forget that I know how to look after myself. Now, how can I help you? A foreign army invades Taris, declares martial law, and locks down all travel to and from the planet? You damn well bet I have a problem with that. If the Sith ever moved in down here, all the swoop gangs would unite against them. We'd use hit-and-run guerrilla tactics to pick them off. Their casualties would be enormous.
Don't fool yourself. The Sith would never commit to that kind of operation. They'd probably do something much more grand and deadly.
But so far, the Sith have stayed out of the Lower City, and our strength is wasted on this stupid gang war. I tried to explain this to Brezhik, but he and his Volkers won't listen. The escape pods? You know, I heard the Sith have been asking around the Upper City about them as well. But you don't look like you're with the Sith.
They might be spies, Gaddon. They might be working for the Sith.
Calm down, Zerdra. If the Sith thought we knew anything useful, they'd have a battalion of troops kicking down our door. No, I think this off-worlder has her own agenda. I suppose I could tell you what I know. It's not like it could do any harm to me or my gang. But it might cause problems for the Volkers, and that's okay in my book. The Volkers stripped those pods clean within hours after they landed. It's too bad we didn't get there first, considering what my spies reported the Volkers found. A female Republic officer named Bastila survived the crash. We Becks don't believe in intergalactic slavery, but the Volkers aren't so picky. They took a prisoner. Normally, the Volkers would take a captured slave and sell them for a nice profit to Davik, or an off-world slaver. But a Republic officer is no ordinary catch.
I still think Bastila is just a Republic officer. That could work to our advantage. Maybe she'll even figure out a way to escape from the Volker base on her own.
She's too valuable to leave with the Volker scum at the base. Brezhik's probably got your Republic friend hidden away somewhere safe until the big swoop race. You'll never find her. I'm afraid your friend has become a pawn in Brezhik's game to take over the lower city. He's offered her up as the Vulkar's share of the prize in the annual Swoop Gang race. By putting up such a valuable prize, Brezhik hopes to win the loyalty of some of the smaller gangs. Their numbers will allow him to finally destroy me and my followers.
So how do you propose we go about rescuing Bastila then? Well, we can't fight all the gangs.
The only hope you have of rescuing Bastila is to somehow win the big season opener of the Swoop race. I might be able to help you with this, if you'd be willing to help us. We both have something to gain here, and much to lose. The Swoop race is for the lower city gangs only. I could sponsor you as a rider for the Hiddenbex this year. If you win the race, you'll win your friend's freedom. But first, you have to do something for me. My mechanics have developed an accelerator for a Swoop engine. A bike with the accelerator installed can beat any other Swoop out there. But the Vulkars stole the prototype from us. They plan to use it to guarantee a victory in this year's Swoop race. I need you to break into their base and steal it back. Getting into the Vulkar base won't be easy. The front doors are locked tight. But I know someone who might be able to get you in the back way. Mission Veo.
Mission? Gaddon, you can't be serious. She's just a kid. How is she supposed to help them with this?
Mission's explored every step of every back alley in the lower city. Plus, she knows the undercity sewers better than anyone. If anyone can get inside the Vulkar base, it's her. She and her Wookiee friend Zalbar are always looking to stir up a little excitement. They like to go exploring in the Undercity, despite the dangers. Your best bet is to look for her in the Undercity, but you'll need some way past the Sith guard post at the elevator. A simple disguise might have worked on the Upper City guard, but the security down here is much tougher. You'll need the proper papers to get past him. Luckily, my gang ambushed one of the Sith patrols headed down to the Undercity. They never made it, and their security papers fell into my hands. Since we're working together now, I suppose I could give them to you in exchange for your uniforms. With the security papers, you won't need a disguise anyway. Good choice. Thanks for the uniforms. You won't need them with these security papers anyway. Now, is there anything else I can do for you? Your time would probably be better spent going after the prototype Swoop engine the Vulkars stole from us, but I'll answer your questions if I can. When I lost my sight in the Swoop bike accident, everyone assumed I would step down as leader of the Hidden Bex and let Brezhik, my most trusted follower, take over. But with my ocular implants, I can still see well enough to lead this gang. And I knew Brezhik wasn't ready to take over yet. Unfortunately, Brezhik didn't agree with me. In a rage, he left to join our arch-rivals, the Black Vulkars. A lot of the younger gang members followed him, and soon he and his followers had taken control of the Vulkar gang. Brezhik is a proud man. My decision was a public humiliation for him. Maybe if I had stepped down, this gang war could have been avoided.
Don't fool yourself, Gaddon. Brezhik wants to control the lower city gangs. If you'd stepped down, he'd have led the Bex against the Vulkars. He wanted this war, one way or another.
I know you're right, Zerdra. Brezhik won't rest until I am dead and the Bex are no more. But it's hard to accept the truth of his betrayal. Your time would probably be better spent going after the prototype Swoop engine the Vulkars stole from us. But I'll answer your questions if I can. Not while the Sith quarantine is in place. Even the fastest smuggler ships can't break the blockade of the fleet surrounding the planet without the proper launch codes. Any ship leaving the Taris atmosphere without the proper codes would be instantly disintegrated by blaster cannons fired by the Sith fleet's automated targeting systems. Feel free to come back anytime. We're not like those Vulkar savages. Strangers are welcome in the Bec base.
You can speak to Gadden if you want, but I've got my eye on you. You try anything and you'll be vaporized before you can say Volker spy.
Ranunu prata dunkul shirkasha, doomed a pike.
Kuni truth black fungible elfa, hoithidan elfa badinova elfa. He a fun gurisa to fidan debat, when bundas.
Manaman atota! Hakki jukrata bola shui chongatong! Chongkin no bunka mulera kunkile! Kunkile no ba! Watende chokolo ono no ku mulera!
Tangabun shan omnang! Wanga kun beast kin ba mulera! Choni yun tun jiji ida dwana! Kava vulpa mulji gumana?
Are behind with your payments. What do you, you think just because you're in some gang, you don't have to give Davik his cut?
Karadumpa kunpa yiya moka paata! Buna nai kachu. Yin kin kuno ba muli rachi kun. Tung na bun shan yun yang. Kaba vol pa mulchi kamana.
Runda di hotonga kun hongkabi. Wana kun bez ching pala mule. Tung king ba nunodek. Tokning chatukunne mulerabes.
Ah, so you want to play this the hard way? Okay.
Tone podo. Rana no prata dunkno sercha. Itju a penki.
Watana wama mulera. Kenjunju pa shak. No wa pule mulera ji. Jonitun turji chiwi itado. Bola una dicek! Bala mures limo wanga kun bisching!
I knew you boys would see reason. Now get out of here.
Too bad. I was looking forward to cracking some heads.
Maybe next time, Candris. Better get this over to Davik. I'll call you if anyone else gets behind on their payments.
Those Valkers are dumber than a Coruscant granite slug. They actually think being in that pathetic little gang of theirs makes them important. Gadon keeps his hidden Bex in line, but Brezhik's getting dreams of grandeur. If Davik's smart, he'll slap that young punk back down. I'm someone you don't want to get on the bad side of. And I'm not one for small talk. I don't have time to stick around here anyway. Davik's got me working on a special assignment.
Chiwi aita ka tong chicha. Agi inko dune chuna mori ra. Tongi wama jikona. Tong kipa nonku nek abog. Chiyokaku. Kinba muli ra dwanaji. Kuyami juski chika nai. Uba baska dwana chichopa muska. Chiska da soki kupa bona na chachu.
There's a bounty on your little green heads. I'm here to collect.
Just crunky to pets limo. Chi ita kanki chana kilikon. Kinba muli ra dwanaji. Kinba noku nixet abog.
That's the plan.